Welcome to Kazakhstan! In this episode, we're gonna climb up this mountain which we don't know the name of, but we're gonna get there. We don't know how much it will take. I mean, how much time it will take and how much energy it will burn, but we're gonna get there.
Kazakhstan, salam!
So recently, I got an invite from the Kazakhstan Tourism to join a week-long adventurous trip across the beautiful southern Kazakhstan. Come witness the grandeur of this majestic land with me in this 5-part web series. With the cold breeze kissing my face and the sweet taste of the rising sun, I welcomed my second morning in Kazakhstan. Good morning, everyone. It's my day 2 in Kazakhstan. I'm still at this Jhabagl village, which is at the foothills of Aksu Jhabagl Natural Reserve. Today we are going to two places. One is Kishkainda and the other one is Ulkkainda. Now, both the places are known for the mountain gorges. Also, there's a waterfall on the way, so we'll stop for the waterfall. And right now, I think I'll just go and have my breakfast. And yeah, that's the scene for today. I'll keep you posted. Morning. You guys sleep well? A powerful Kazaki's traditional breakfast, and we were all set for the adventurous trip planned for the day. The drive was truly fantastic, with a lot of single track stretches, blind corners, and the stunning scenery with sun-kissed fields giving that golden aura to the place.
Yesterday with you, we saw the river Aksu, and this is river Jhabagla. And the natural reserve is called Aksu Jhabagla by the name of these two rivers.
So we have stopped at the first viewpoint for the day. It looks amazing. There is Jhabagla River flowing right next to this place, and there's some really nice views around. So yeah, let me show you around.
After absorbing the overwhelming beauty of the mountain gorges as much as we could, we soon started for our next stop, waterfalls of Shirkhainde.
So we have taken another stopover. There's a waterfall over here, and we'll have to trek down a little, and then there's a viewpoint from where you can actually see the waterfall.
So yeah,
we are gonna trek down from here.
How is your experience so far?
It's so beautiful today, but I'm like worried about this trek. We'll see how this goes. We're all going down together.
No. I can walk you. No, guys, let the girl go first.
It's actually very slippery, and everybody is holding their hands and going down, and I'm actually holding this gimbal and going down. Yeah, crazy. It's difficult.
Dear guests, we are now in the waterfall of Kishkainda. In second half of May, the ibex females, the mountain goats, come to these rocks to make the babies. So the local people call this place the birth house of ibexes. They stay here for 2 weeks in these rocks with their babies, and then go up. And the whole gorge and the waterfall and the river called Kishkainda, which means the small birch tree area. You can see that mainly the forest here consists of juniper tree, but there are the lines of the special birch trees. They are called their endemic tree called Turkistan birch.
It wasn't a giant waterfall as I had expected, primarily as we were visiting this place in an off season with less rainfall during this period of year. But the tranquility that the place had to offer was of no match.
Thank you. get photos and videos of the snow leopards regularly for their photo traps.
Oh, there are snow leopards over here?
Yes, on the top of that kind of glaciers. Altitude of this is about 3800.
3800?
Yeah.
The stunning views of the place was definitely worth catching the eyes of the photographers and people looking for solitude. Being traveling with a group of content creators, we never missed a chance to take a halt to experience the different shades of nature with myriad of colors.
So we have reached the final stop point for the day. It's called Ulken Kainda. And there's a small hut over here, so we'll have our lunch over here. And then we are planning to go for a hike further ahead. I'm not sure how much we'll be able to do, but then, yeah, that's the scene for now. This drink is called Kampot, and this is one of my favorite drinks here. It's made out of cherry, and they make it by themselves. They grow cherry right next to their house. They boil cherries and make this drink, and it tastes really, really good. So, starting the hike now. I'm not sure how much will we go, but then excited.
Feeling great, bro.
Who else got wet?
Not me.
I am completely wet.
Same, man, same.
Not
my
me.
Shoes are like drenched.
Not me.
You did.
I got wet.
Cheers, man.
So finally made it to the top, and it was a very long trek. And you know, one thing I realized was trekking is more about a mental game and not really a physical game, because after a point I was just literally pushing myself because this gimbal is very heavy. But yeah, we made it. We made it to the top.
And there I was, standing at the top of this peak, appreciating the allure of this gigantic masterpiece. Sometimes the journey itself is a part of your travel experience. Something I realized as I ventured onto this trek and peered down at the river flowing far below.
Hey, we are back!
Finally made it!
Finally!
2 days had passed by in Kazakhstan, and all I could think of while trekking down was my relationship with the place. It just felt as if I belonged there. With those beautiful, charming people around, guiding me into the quiet, reflective moments which you rarely get when you travel.
So done for the day. It was a very adventurous day. We went for a hiking. We saw some really cool landscapes. We saw some really cool mountains. And now we are back to the hotel. Everybody is very tired, so we'll take some rest, and then I don't know what's the plan for the evening.
Traveling isn't always comfortable. Sometimes it's taxing, sometimes it hurts, but that's okay. The journey you take transforms you. It leaves a mark on your soul, on your body, and your heart. You always end up taking a part of that place, hopefully leaving something good behind. And that's all for the day. What happens next? Stay tuned for the next part of my point of view Kazakhstan.
So dear guests, now we will...
Yeah, cheers.
Cheers, man.
Yeah, I'm sure, yeah.